Okay, I felt like some girl needed to hear this because I wish I knew this when I was younger. Your friends that try to compete with you, and you know what I'm talking about, like those little passive aggressive, one-upping, subtle comments, they are so threatened by you. And you might not think that you're a threatening person, but these girls see something in you that they do not have. Be very cautious of these friends because they do not have your best interests at heart.
Three things you may be doing that making you unhappy without even realizing. You don't spend enough alone time. And I'm not talking about sitting at home and watching a TV show and spending time by yourself eating popcorn. No, solitude, quality time. You need to figure out who you are, what you want, and how you're gonna get it. No distractions are allowed. You're impatient, like a lot of us, but life is a journey, and getting to become the person that you dream of and achieve all the things that you want takes a lot of time. So trust the process and put in the work. There's time, I promise. You don't think you deserve to be happy. And that, I think, is a big thing that a lot of us miss. Sometimes in between all the distraction and hustle and vision boards and manifestations, we never actually stop, sit with ourselves, and truly make sure that we are not the one who are blocking all this energy and all that goodness come into our lives.
I realize that when I am in crisis, when I have quote unquote fucked up, my response is, you fucking idiot. How could you? Of course. What did you expect? If I spoke to my friends like I used to speak to myself, I would have no friends. So if you do talk to yourself out loud, and I do, make sure that the words are loving and supportive and nourishing. Start the work of being your own best friend.
Years ago, my therapist taught me a trick to increase my confidence that I still use today. She said that I need to stop asking myself, am I even good enough for that? And start asking myself, is that even good enough for me?
If you didn't have any insecurities at all, who would you be? How would you carry yourself? How would you view yourself? This is the version of yourself that you should be striving to become each and every day. Okay, you should learn to own your insecurities. You should learn to embrace all of who you are so that you can truly live your best life. You can't live your best life unless you're being your best you, but you can't be your best you if you're not even being yourself. A lot of you guys are so caught up in the way that other people perceive you that you forget who you are. And as a result, you are living for other people when in reality, these people don't even care about you because they're worried about their insecurities. You have a chance to liberate not only yourself, but other people by leading by example.
Three things that are making you unhappy. You hang out with unhappy people. Now, I'm not saying that everyone has to be happy all the time. We all go through the motion and that's totally understandable. But please make a point to have people around you that not only vent about their problems, but also vent about their joys. You haven't found your purpose. And that's the hardest thing to do in life. But if you can identify three things, you know that your purpose is very close. What are your interests? What are you passionate about? Once you find that, you figure out if you have the skill set for that passion or that interest. And then the third thing, is it going to be helpful to other people? Once you check off these three things, your purpose is right around the corner. You're stuck in your past. Being stuck in the past is not only completely robs you from enjoying the present, but it also like walking with your back towards the door. You can only see what's behind you, not what's in front of you. And that's where we want to focus.